Okay, what's happening today? The sun. That's easy. I'm an expert on the sun. Ah, where's the sun? Where did it go? What did I do? Geo friend, something's happened to the sun. It's gone.
It's night, Cosmo. Is the sun on the other side of the earth?
Oops. Yeah, there it is. Right where it should be.
That's good, Cosmo. What would happen if the sun did disappear?
Oh, cool question. I've got the perfect simulation to run. The sun is huge. It's 109 times bigger than planet Earth. The sun only looks small because it's so far away. How far? 93 million miles is how far... If the sun disappeared, the first thing you would notice on Earth is how dark it has become. You would still see the stars, but the moon has disappeared. The moon is only visible because it reflects the sun's light. Without the sun, people will need fires and flashlights and electricity to light their lives. It's also starting to get cold here on Earth. The Earth's average temperature would drop to 32 degrees Fahrenheit after the first 7 days, and then to minus 100 degrees Fahrenheit by the end of the first year. At these freezing temperatures, all the lakes, rivers, and oceans will freeze. But look, life. Deep under the ocean, underwater volcanoes and geothermal vents keep some of the water warm. Some life forms, like bacteria and worms, might be able to live here. Is that your stomach rumbling? I've got some bad news. Plants use the energy from the sun to make their own food in a process called photosynthesis. Without the sun, small plants would die in a few days or weeks. Larger plants, like big trees, would also likely die from the cold. Animals, including people, rely on plants for food energy. Sometimes we eat plants, and sometimes we eat animals that eat plants. With no sun, we could grow plants under special light bulbs in greenhouses, but we couldn't make enough food to feed all the world's hungry people and animals. Whoa, is it getting hard to breathe? Plants and animals live in balance. Plants breathe in carbon dioxide and breathe out oxygen. Animals breathe in oxygen and breathe out carbon dioxide. Humans breathe in over 13 trillion pounds of oxygen every year. It would take a few thousand years, but eventually the air would run out of oxygen. Humans would need to produce oxygen in a laboratory and wear oxygen tanks like scuba divers. So, what do you think?
Let me think. A dark and freezing cold planet with no oxygen and no food? No way, Cosmo. I'm going back to bed. Bye.
All right, bye, Geo friend. Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. Humans depend on the sun in so many ways. Did you know that you can use the sun to tell time? What if you built a sundial? Step 1, find an adult. Step 2, gather a paper plate, some Play-Doh, and a pencil. Step 3, use the Play-Doh to stick the pencil in the middle of the plate, standing straight up and down. Step 4, take the sundial outside and place it in a sunny and protected area. For best results, start this process in the morning. Step 5, draw a line on the paper plate where the shadow from the pencil falls. Write the time of day on this line. Step 6, come back every hour and mark the length and position of the shadow on the paper plate. Don't forget to record the time for each observation. And now you've made a sundial. Have someone try and use your sundial to tell the time. Happy experimenting, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!